tonight to see on this viral cell phone video. Police say four African-American students hurled racial slurs and then physically attacked Asian students coming home from Central High School in Olney. Live at SEPTA headquarters tonight is Action News reporter Bob Brooks with more on this. Bob.
In the last 10 minutes, NBC 10 has learned that four young students have been charged now in connection with a brutal beating on SEPTA. Included in those charges, ethnic intimidation. You're watching NBC 10 News at 11. I'm Jim Rosenfield.
And I'm Jacqueline London. It's a story we first brought you last night at 11. That attack on Asian American students drawing anger and remorse and now leading to a bigger discussion about race and safety outside of the classroom. NBC 10's Matt DeLucia is live outside SEPTA headquarters in Center City. Matt, these students are facing serious charges.
And you talked about some of those charges there. This is something that some people were really hoping to see sooner rather than later here. The DA's office just approved those charges, as you mentioned, within the last few minutes. Those include aggravated assault, ethnic intimidation, criminal conspiracy, and simple assault. One of those students is also being charged with attempted robbery for trying to steal one of the victim's AirPods there. Now, it's been a day since that viral video started circulating on social media of that attack, and since then we have seen several people come out opposing what had happened there, upset, angry. Tonight a mother is apologizing, one of the victims remains in the hospital, and city leaders are trying to find ways to make these students feel safer.
All of us were devastated by what we saw.
City Councilmember Helen Gim spent much of her day talking about the attack on a group of Asian American students on the Broad Street line Wednesday afternoon. It was caught on video, but we at NBC 10 have decided to stop showing it because the victims are minors, and one reached out to us saying it was traumatic to continue seeing it. The mother of a 12-year-old girl accused of punching and kicking another says she is embarrassed and ashamed.
I was extremely hurt, and this is why I needed to meet with you guys publicly so that you know that my family is very sincerely apologetic about what happened to their child, because we all pray that our children make it home safe from school.
She says her daughter ran away from home 2 weeks ago and only saw her last night after the incident, insisting that it was not racially motivated.
I want them to know, you don't have to be afraid of us. My daughter did not mean it. When she gets the opportunity to, she will give a sincere apology.
SEPTA's police chief argues otherwise.
This was an attack based on ethnicity, and ethnic slurs were used by the attackers, hence why we're charging ethnic intimidation.
Three others are charged in the attack. Councilmember Gim stopped by Jefferson Hospital tonight to visit one of the victims. Earlier, she met with parents and the principal at Central High School and then hosted a call with the community about the problems facing students.
There's no question that there are many in the Asian American community who are deeply concerned when you see young people exhibiting behaviors that are, terrifying and are serious.
And SEPTA's police chief says there will now be an escort service available for Central High students who would rather get a ride home with a police officer. Live in Central.